Hello, welcome to another Unity tutorial with me, Romy Fozy. And in this tutorial, we are going to discuss on the new terrain package and also the terrain samples. And here, I have a project with a terrain object on it, and I've already set up a texture. Here under the paint texture, I've already set a grass layer. And also, I've already set have a tree model here, and we are going to create those three in the scenes here. And see what kind of problems that we might encounter and how to optimize them. Okay, so let's go to the terrain, and I'm not going to explain all of the terrain feature because I think there is a lot of tutorial there that are already explaining this. But there is one thing maybe a lot of user are skipping on those on these features is as you can see here in the new terrain we have this stamp terrain, and this is quite nice to create a stamp effect on the terrain. So it will create a certain stamp with a certain height. So if we change the height here, you'll see that it will create something like this. But the brushes is not very interesting. So let's just reset this, undo this, and we can get brushes from the asset store. So if we go to the asset store and then type terrain samples. Yeah, there you go. And here, this is the assets that I was talking about, the Unity, the terrain tool samples. And just download this and then import it. So I'm going to import this. Once the assets is imported, you'll see that we have a lot of new features. A lot of new brushes. And we can use that for stamping and creating mountains, interesting mountains, very easily. So it's still importing assets. Okay, I think it's done. So let's go back to the scene and then unselect the terrain and then select this again. And you'll see once we select it, we will have a lot more new brushes. And here, starting from these brushes is actually a terrain data samples from a satellite images. So if you see here, you see it will create a very interesting one, and we can increase our brush size. But in terms of a brush features, it's not very interesting because we cannot rotate the object. So in order to do that, Unity already provide a new assets, and to get those assets we need to go to the package manager and then make sure we enable the show preview package. And when it's finished loading the packages, we need to import the terrain package. So let's go down here, and we have terrain tools over here, and let's just install this. So right now it's still installing and it's importing the assets. Okay, so now it's successfully installed the terrain assets. Let's just check if it's installed or not. Okay, yeah, it's installed. So now I'm going to close this window here. And then if we go back to our terrain, you'll see under our stroke, we have a lot of new options and including rotation. So we can rotate this, we can adjust the size. So I'm going to expand the size here. But unfortunately, the shortcut using the square bracket is not working anymore for increasing and decreasing. So currently, we need to set it from here. I'm not sure if there are any shortcut, but we need to check on those later. But if we change the size here, you'll see that we can rotate it now. So now we can rotate the stamp brush. So if we rotate and create it here, you see that we will create a very interesting mountain. And if we select the other shape, and then we can also increase the height. You see, we can create a very, very nice mountain. So let's just create something here. And now I'm going to go to the texture, and when we import the terrain tools, we will have a lot of effect, a sculpt effect to create bridge terrace. And if we press this, this will automatically create terrace for our mountains, as you can see here. And let's go to the paint texture, and I'm going to add a layer, and I've already created a rock layer. And in order to create new layer, you can just create new layer and then select the texture that you want to use. And for the rock layer, we can just select the brushes and start painting on top of our mountain object. Okay, so yeah, that is pretty much for the new terrain tools. And you can test on all of the new features here to see what it does. But the next thing that I want to talk about is the trees here. And this is for you that having issues if you're using a custom model of your trees. So for example, if you try to add a new tree, and then you have a model that you've created, and you want to use that tree. So for example, I have this one model I've created in Blender, and if I add this, okay, so we can just draw the tree over here. You see it's getting drawn, but we have an issue over here. The tree random height doesn't get applied, and also the rotation, we don't have random tree rotation. The random tree rotation is disabled. And in order to fix this, we need to create a new empty game object. And then we need to set the tree object as a child of that game object. And I'm going to reset its rotation here. And let's just rename the game object to tree. And we need to add a LOD group component, and then just disable or delete the other LOD and set the cult version very small, so around 2% or 1%, and then set the first LOD to this object here. So let's just drag with the LOD number 0 selected and then add the render, and now we have this tree. So now we can just set this tree as a prefabs, and then let's just delete the tree. And if we go back to our terrain and then press edit tree, we can switch the object to the prefabs that we have just created. And now we have this random rotation. So if we go back to our tree areas here, let's just delete this and then let's just try to draw a new trees. And right now the trees will have random rotations and also random height. If we see it from the front view here, you'll see that the tree will have random height, as you can see. Let's just increase the tree height differences, and then yeah, let's try to delete this again and then draw it again. So this should, yeah, as you can see, we have different height for our trees and also different rotation. And now for the other thing that we can optimize here, if I try to change my camera to this position here by selecting the camera and then hold Control Shift F, if I go to the game view, you see that our badges is crazy high. And that is because I've already created a texture using the texture and the leaves. We have two textures, and this material is already being set to the game object. And I've already assigned the material to the correct slot here. So the material is being applied to the right object. But we can tweak this here. It shouldn't have this very high draw call, because we only use one object, one material. And in order to lower this number here, we can just enable this options here, the enable GPU instancing. So if I press this, you see we reduce the batches by halves. And if we select the leaf here and then set this to enable GPU instancing also, you see that we've already lowered the batches. But we can push this further down by selecting both of our camera our material here, and then under the shader, let's just set this to standard, and we are less by 10 draw call. And here, the object, the leaf material, we should set this to fade, so it will have a nice transparent effect. We can also set this to cutout, but cutout introduce more harsher edges, and fade give us more softer edges. And here I've enabled the emissions and set this to a slightly dark green, so we will have some sort of translucency. Compared if we disable the emission, the shadow will be too dark. Okay, and another thing that we can optimize here is if we select the terrain and then we go to the terrain settings, we have this draw instance options. And by default, this is disabled. So if we go to the game view here, if it's disabled, you see the batches goes increase again to 178. And if I use this, it goes down back to the 22 draw call. So with this optimization, I hope you can now design a very interesting looking terrain with the mountain stem and stuff. And also you can randomize your own custom tree if you are not using the speed tree from the assets editor. Sorry, not the assets editor, the asset store. And the other thing is if you try to add a image effects using the post-processing stack, the batches will also get increased as you add more effects. But if it's running on desktop, you should be fine because current generation graphic processing unit or VGA such as NVIDIA GeForce or Radeon, it can handle very high draw calls batches. But for mobile, you need to keep this in check, make sure it doesn't go over 200 or 300. Less than 200 or even less than 100 should be the target that you are trying to achieve. Okay, so if you like this video, please hit that subscribe button and press those like button. And thanks for watching, and I hope I see you in another episode.